My name is Amir. I'm from Paterson, New Jersey, and I'm here with my fiance, Chris. Chris is a major skeptic. He has no belief whatsoever.
Come in.
Well, I have no idea who Theresa is. I believe my fiance is crazy for believing in this stuff in mediums.
I'll prove you wrong today.
Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Amir.
Amir, nice
yes.
to meet you.
Chris.
Likewise.
Chris, pleasure. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having
Thank
us.
Come
on
for
in.
Having us.
You guys can have a seat. Make yourself comfortable.
I am very nervous. To get Christopher here today was a challenge. I feel like my fiance needs the experience so that he can enjoy life a little bit more.
I always tell my clients that this is not about you believing in mediums. Doesn't matter to me if you believe in what I do. But I want you to believe in the fact that your loved ones are with you. Okay, so what is happening right now is something a little unusual. I'm just gonna say this. You look like a very nice young man. But I didn't even get through my speech, and all I was hearing was, tell him not to be so angry.
Yeah, I'm very angry, you know.
How do you connect with the number 26?
That's the day my mom died.
Okay. So you know that your mother said, I just got the goosebumps. Did you just get the chills?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That was your mother's soul.
My mom was an amazing woman. She was my best friend. And the day she passed away, I didn't want to live. Like, my life was taken away from me. My best friend was gone. The person who was gonna guide me the right way for the rest of my life was no longer there.
Do you connect with the butterflies, or do you see butterflies?
Oh my God, this is crazy. What did I tell you in the car? Before I came here in the car, I told him if they bring up butterflies, I'm gonna freak out.
Yeah, my daughter, everything's about butterflies with her. Every single thing. Her theme in her room, her birthday theme, her everything is butterflies.
I call her my little butterfly.
Perfect. She says, I want you to know that my soul will never leave you.
My daughter's like obsessed with butterflies. And when she said that, it was like, oh my God, I told you. I'm speechless. I really am.
Your mom talks about the sun. Do you have a son?
It's on his way.
Oh, shut up!
Yeah, she's pregnant.
We just found out it's a boy. It's first boy.
First boy in the family.
It's 18 years.
Perfect. So your mother knows that you're having a son.
It's crazy, right?
So you know that when your son is placed in your arms, know that your mother's soul will be right beside you.
It's crazy.
When she said son, it was amazing.
In my head, I says, how the hell this lady knows that, that I'm gonna have a son? That's what came to my head. That's the question that popped in my head.
Oh my God. If you don't believe it now, you have issues. It was amazing. Nobody knew. We just found out.
Were you in some type of accident where you feel that you should have been more seriously injured?
Yeah.
Okay.
8 years ago.
Okay.
I was in a motorcycle accident.
Because I was told you were saved. Like, there's no way that you should have survived that accident.
Yeah, I shouldn't have been alive, no.
Did you see someone at that accident?
Let me tell you something. This creeps me out, I'll tell you like that. I hit a wall at 150 miles an hour. And I landed on the opposite side of the highway in the fast lane where I should have been ran over. And my father and my brother, they were behind me, but my father told me right before I woke up from hitting the ground, a lady dressed in entire white came. She was there, physically there. He physically saw her there and prayed over me. And minutes later, the cops were there and the lady was nowhere to be seen. It's like she disappeared.
And not many people know that. Is that correct?
Nobody knew about that story.
So you know that you were saved.
Yeah, that I believe. She didn't know I got into a motorcycle accident. No one told her that. I'm not wearing shorts so you could see my injuries. I don't know a name of this person. My dad doesn't know a name, doesn't know anything about this person. That was mind-boggling.
Oh, this is interesting. Did your mom die at home?
Yes.
She asked me on the couch. Did she pass on the couch?
Yeah, she was on the couch.
Okay. She said, tell him I didn't suffer. Your mother made me feel like that she just fell asleep.
8 years ago, my mom was found on a couch, dead. We don't know what happened. My mom had lupus. Today she could be normal like you and I, talk, cook, clean. The next day she'd be like a vegetable. She couldn't move, couldn't talk right, couldn't move her fingers. It was the weirdest sickness I've ever seen. So we don't know how she passed. We just know that my mom didn't wake up.
This is very hard for me to say this to you. She says, I want you to stop going over that because that's what you go over. Is that correct? This is what's fueling your anger. This is why you can't heal. So she says that when you have the dreams of me, is that correct?
All the time.
And she's always smiling.
Yeah.
She says, I am trying to show you that my soul is at peace. I wasn't afraid when I died. Do you understand that?
Yeah, okay.
Okay?
Okay. When Theresa told me that my mom said she didn't suffer, that's the best thing I've ever heard in my life. I feel like I got closure with my mom.
So know that your mom says, I want you to be able to love your fiance more than the anger you carry connected to my departure. You understand that?
I understand that.
So, I want to thank you both for coming. It was an absolute pleasure. And I hope that you know that through after everything your family has been through, that your mom's soul is at peace.
I want to share something with you. No one telling me that my mother's at peace, that my mother's soul's with me. I can't believe no one. And I believe in what you did with me today. And I say that sincerely. Thank you.
Well, thank you. And that's why I love what I do.
This experience gave me something I haven't felt in a long time. Whatever way she hears it, whatever way she gets her information, you know, through her spirits, however she does it, today she made me a believer.
Very nice to meet you.
Thank you
so much.
Good luck to you. I really appreciate everything you did.